Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about Helmholtz resonators. Obviously, this is a term that's very common in the literature. A lot of people talk about them. I get a lot of calls about them. Well, why don't we use a Helmholtz instead of a diaphragmatic? Why don't we use a Helmholtz instead of a membrane? Always type, amount, and position in a room. So let's walk through what Helmholtz really are so you get a feel for them. They're really a device that, a sound absorption device that's very frequency specific. They're very narrow in the amount of absorption. You might get 40 cycles to 45. You might get a 5 hertz window with them, but you never get anything more than that. So you need a lot of them tuned to different frequencies. They can be very effective, but you need a lot of units in a room to deal with all the problems that small room acoustics, low frequency energy management contain. So they're not really used a lot in small room acoustics because of that, but I think it's going to be interesting to kind of walk through the process. So used today in cars because they pick out certain frequencies out of complex sounds. You can, you know, if you have a 40 to a 43 cycle range, you want to absorb some of that, smooth it out so it blends with the other octaves in that range. You can do that. Helmholtz resonators are used in Chrysler products, the Ram pickups, they use them a lot. Motorcycle exhaust, they use them because I'm actually designing a Helmholtz resonator now for Scania, which is a truck company in Sweden. We have an exhaust system that's really noisy, so we've measured the noise, and then we're going to design some of our carbon technology within a Helmholtz resonator to deal with that noise. So let's talk a little bit about the resonator itself. What is it like? It's a body or a chamber. We've all seen them. Over here, it's a body or a chamber, and then it's got a neck. Or you could look at something like this. So it has a neck, and obviously energy moves through that, goes down through here, and then gets the air molecules inside going. So we have the neck, we have the body, we have the opening. You can see we have a lot of variables that we have to deal with here. So resonators are difficult. You have to understand the physics of many, many parts of them in order to get them to work right. So we have the hole or neck, air vibrating back and forth. And then the air inside the resonator acts as a spring, okay? So you get a lot of air inside of it moving up and down like a spring. So, and then that is connected to the total mass of air in there. So you have this mass of air defined by the size of the container, the opening of the neck, the narrowness of the neck, and then that mass of air moves up and down as a spring. So the term for that is adiabatic, okay? Adiabatic. So not diabetes, but adiabatic. It's a process that we use in physics. So how does it influence what we do? Well, it's very frequency dependent because we have a certain size, we have a certain volume, and we have a certain size of our opening, and all three of those variables have to be controlled. So it's the composition also of the diaphragm or of the Helmholtz resonator itself that has bearing on what we're trying to do. The neck and obviously the chamber. So lots of variables, lots of calculations. Takes a little bit of experience and testing, okay? Here's a good example of a Helmholtz resonator that we're all familiar with, and that's a small glass Coke bottle. You blow across the opening on that, which we've all done, it's about 185 cycles. So what does that mean? Anything above 185 cycles will be absorbed. Anything below it will not. So that's the resonant frequency of that Helmholtz resonator. So I hope this helps. Just remember, it's a chamber with air. You're forcing air through a neck, and all of that volume of the chamber, the diameter of the neck, and the diameter of the slot all has to be calculated. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support, and if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button, so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there, so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.